and say, hey, hey, hey. Put a hump in your back and say, hey, hey, hey. Put a hump in your back and say, hey, hey, hey. Put a hump in your back and say, hey, hey. Let's go.
Touch the floor like your legs are broke. Take that big old booty, girl, screw up the ground. You can do it up and down, around and round. As long as that pussy ain't still dancing, make all the niggas look at that.
What's up, YouTube? It's Kira here, and we're back with another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Kira Ray, and if you're returning, then welcome back. Centennial is next week. I'm so excited. Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated was founded November 12, 1922 on the campus of Butler University in Indianapolis, Indiana, and it is currently 2022, so that means it has been 100 years since we've been on this earth, and I am super excited. This is my first boulet, and for it to be the centennial, like, talk about timing. I'm going to Centennial with another one of my sisters, a part of my chapter on campus, and I leave, I want to say I leave July 11th, and Centennial is from the 11th to the 16th, so I'm beyond excited, and I cannot wait to be around all my sororers and just having a good time. Leading up to Centennial, every day this week, I will be releasing a SG Rho-related video. I'm not gonna tell you guys what videos are coming. You're just gonna have to make sure you are subscribed and staying tuned to my channel, because why wouldn't you wanna be? Let me know, sis. Let's get into today's video. All right, so I'm gonna be talking to you guys about why I joined Sigma Gamma Rho and also my favorite and most challenging things about being a part of the organization. Okay, so let's go back. I used to be the kind of person, and I mentioned this in my, I guess, like, reveal coming out video that I posted a couple months ago. I used to be the kind of person that, like, just was not interested in Greek life at all. Like, if you were to ask me freshman year, oh, Kira, are you gonna join a sorority? I was like, no, you will not catch me. I was like, it is not for me. It's not something that I want to be a part of. And I mostly had that mindset because growing up, I guess whenever I would hear Greek life around me, I just noticed how, I guess, people changed once they became a part of an organization. And I just wasn't interested in risking that. And I felt like growing up, I just always found myself in the position of feeling like I needed to change myself in order to fit in. And going into college, I just was not interested in doing that again. So yeah, I was like, I'm not gonna join Greek life. Also, I was always surrounded by, like, mostly AKAs growing up, and I felt obligated to join that organization if I were to join D9, and it just didn't feel right, I guess, in my spirit. So I was just like, you know, I'm not gonna do it at all. Fast forward to my sophomore year, I was talking to one of my good friends at the time, who actually was the president of the chapter on my campus. She was talking to me about SG Rho, and around this time, I also was like doing my own research, because I was like, you know, maybe I am a little interested in Greek life. Talking to her in the car, we were hanging out that day, and she was just explaining to me more about Sigma and like the mission and, you know, kind of like just what we're all about. And I was like, wow, like, I feel like this really aligns with what I want to do. I do want to become an educator, and our seven founders were all educators, and it just kind of seemed perfect. Eventually, I want to do both of these things. One is open up a performing arts school, and then two, I want to start up dance programs in HBCUs, simply because the only reason why I came to PWI is because they offer the kind of dance training that I am interested in. And dance programs at HBCUs, they're just not as strong, and I don't really like that. So I'm like, well, I'm gonna get my degree and I'm gonna go back and teach and change that. And just, yeah, allowing people of color to have more access to more technical dance training, I guess you could say. Those are my goals, and being a part of this organization, like, Sigma just sounded like the way to go, and sounded like the best thing that could help me reach that goal. So that's why I joined. Also, one more thing, our mission statement is all about education, health awareness, and leadership development, and those are like three things that pique my interest, and I already have some experience in all three of those areas, and it's something that I want to continue, you know, to involve myself in my future career slash life. So Sigma, it all just seemed right, and, you know, I prayed about it, and I'm a big, like, you know, person, like, I'm listening to God, I'm gonna listen to what he has for me. And when it came around the time when I, like, I guess made the decision to try and join this organization, like, everything just felt right. And I felt like God was really telling me, like, Kira, like, this is the time for you to join this. This is something that's supposed to be part of your life. So, you know, I just trusted him and I was like, here we are. So yeah, that's why I joined Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated. And yes, I will be saying the full thing from time to time because why not? We the baddest in the land, why not? So now let's move on as to my favorite things about being part of this organization. I've got three things. Number one, of course, is the fact that I feel like I have just been submersed in a community of people who will help me reach my goals. As I mentioned already, I want to be an educator, and the fact that our seven founders are educators, and I feel like a lot of people a part of the organization have a passion for education, like that really feeds my soul, and it's something that I love being a part of the community because I know that we are all like standing as one and helping each other reach our goals in some way or another. So that's just really important to me. And it's just cool. Like, we're just really cool. So that's reason number one. You could just say like the connections that I get to make and the outreach and programs that I get to be a part of now that I'm a part of the organization. All of them feed my soul, that being because my soul loves education. There we go. Number two, my second favorite reason about being a part of this organization is, of course, strolling. Like, it's so much fun. Before I joined, I always felt like I was missing out on something that was key to my culture. Being at a PWI, it's already really hard to, I guess, find a community of Black people because I'm at a PWI. So when I found out that D9 was on my campus, like, it was just like, wow, like, this is something that I can be a part of that can really help me connect to my culture and to my Black community here and just, you know, be a part of something, you know? Yeah, I'm gonna talk about this later, but it's very hard being a dance major, so finding something that could help me get out of the dance department and something that I actually enjoy being a part of is fun. Getting out there on the yard and like strolling with people. And I'm a dance major, like I've already mentioned. And so strolling comes easily to me. So it's just kind of like fun getting to dance, so to speak, with people that I don't dance with on a daily basis. So yeah, it's just a lot of fun and I'm just really happy. Moving on to the third reason as to why I love being a part of Sigma Gamma Rho, that is the friendships that I have made. So there are people a part of my chapter who I knew of before I joined, but I wasn't close to them, so to speak. However, being a part of this organization, I've become a lot closer with them. And these were people that I'd been wanting to come close to, but because of, you know, going through the years of college and, you know, everyone's schedule and all this stuff, doing different things, it was hard and we grew apart. However, joining the organization, I was able to reconnect and reconvene with everyone and just strengthen my friendship and love for these people. So yeah, that's I guess my last favorite thing. Actually, there are a lot of favorite things that I have about being part of this organization, but I'm not gonna go into them today. I'm just gonna give you my top three. So now let's move on to the most challenging things about being a part of the organization. I really only have two things for this. The first is time management. It is so hard for me to manage my time between two things that have equal priority, and that is dance and this organization. It is so hard being a fine arts major, and a lot of people don't know and understand this. Like, we are so busy, like, so busy. Like, I can barely go to football games. I can barely hang out with my friends, like, on a regular, or go home to visit my family in Houston because I'm always in rehearsal. And I always feel so bad because I'm like, I have dance. And so Greek life, it can have its own demands as well. And so trying to just figure out, like, oh, when can I be here and when can I not be here? Like, it usually never coincides. Like, I'm always having to give up something in order to make it to this or make it to that. So just, it's been really hard just trying to find a balance between Greek life and dance life. And it's really just being here at this school. I don't know what it's like on other campuses, but when you joining this dance department, like, and you ask, oh, is Greek life possible, like, they usually say yes, because it is for people that join Wright sororities, but they don't know how D9 sororities function, and it's a whole different ball game compared to Wright sororities. So it was very difficult. That's all I'm gonna say. It was very hard to manage my time between dance and the sorority when in the process of me, like, wanting to join and expressing my interest. So that's all I'm gonna say about that. But we made it, y'all. We got our letters. We made it. Yeah, so I just really have to make sure I keep open communication with my dance people and my sorority people, just to, you know, let them know like where my mind is at, where I'm dealing with. But that's the number one thing just really challenging about being a part of sorority. And then the second thing is, honestly, it's just one thing. That's pretty much it. I really like being a part of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated. And like, most of my challenges come from just being a dance major as well. So that's pretty much it, y'all. We chilling. We're loving it. Sigma, baby. Sigma is the only way to go, okay? The only way. You just can't complain. Like, there's just nothing to complain about when you're in Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated. So if you wanna join a sorority, you know, Sigma should be at the top. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. Again, I will be releasing a video every single day this week, so make sure you are subscribed and staying tuned and watching, because you will not be disappointed. And to all my sororities out there, I am so happy I get to call you guys a sister now, and I hope to see all y'all at Centennial. Y'all, we gonna turn up, and I cannot wait. So yes, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.